Linux 6.15 is officially out. While this is not a headline-grabbing release, it does deliver a steady stream of updates across file systems, drivers, and hardware support, particularly for AMD and RISC-V platforms. Also, quick note, there's a lot of new subscribers to the show and the channel lately, which, by the way, thanks and welcome. So if you haven't seen this, how I cover these kinds of topics on the show, this is going to be quite technical, but I also try to explain why it would matter to users as we go along. So even if you aren't that type of person who wants to follow the ins and outs of kernel development, I think you'll still find this topic interesting. Let's start with a feature that could speed things up in a big way for AMD users. This release adds support for the INVLPGB instruction on AMD systems that support it. So like, for example, Zen 3 and later. It allows the kernel to invalidate TLB entries on remote CPUs without needing to send IPIs, without having to wait for remote CPUs to handle these interrupts, and with less interruption to what was running on those CPUs. So basically, less overhead and faster performance, especially for AMD Zen 3 and newer systems. Also, there's some kernel changes that are practical, and there's also some that are a little bit contentious. So the new security hook for the IOU ring subsystem ships with Linux 6.15, even though there were some heated criticisms from Linus Torvalds himself, and Linus questioned its purpose and the complexity it adds. Also, speaking of things that are contentious, Rust continues creeping into the kernel. Nova is a new Rust-based successor to the Nuvo driver for NVIDIA GPUs. It's a fresh take on open source NVIDIA drivers, and it might finally fix some of the long-standing NVIDIA-related pain on Linux, but also there's still people who are not going to like it because of the Rust thing, but I think this is overall a good thing because more improvements to NVIDIA graphics drivers is good for the people who are using NVIDIA hardware, so I'm all for that. File systems also got some love in this release. We have a huge performance boost with XFAT optimizations, which is especially nice if you use large external storage because thanks to these optimizations, deleting an 80 gigabyte file, 80 was massively faster after testing. So down from about 4 minutes to a mere 1.6 seconds, which is crazy. So whether you're using AMD or messing with file systems or just want your network to stack to perform better, Linux 6.15 is going to be an update everyone will want. But as usual, distributions will begin integrating the update based on their own timeline. Typically, you wouldn't update the kernel yourself. I mean, you technically can, but most people should just sit back and let the updates come to them.